going to review that regard drill. I'm here. I have my frames. I'm going to frame up, post my foot, and shrimp. The second I create that space, I'm going to insert my foot into a butterfly hook. Drive my bottom foot through, hit the butterfly guard, send him back. Here, just reviewing this, put in my butterfly hook, and I'm using that as a hook to pull myself through. Driving my bottom knee under, sitting pat up. Questions on that part of it? We've been doing it for 2 weeks now, but questions on that part? Alright, so we're here. Now we're going to start, after you've done that, we're going to start with just the head snap guillotine. So, we're here, I'm prone with pad, for whatever reason, I just feel like attacking. So I'm going to grab the bald spot on the back of Pat's head, wherever he can go bald. Got a beautiful head of hair for his itch. Look. And I'm going to cup his chin and head just like I would a football. I don't know how many of you played football, but you cup it. 1 point, your hand, 1 point, your bicep, right? I'm doing the same thing with Pat's head. And I'm grabbing the fatty part of my palm. Right here, locking in. All I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to fall towards the side of the head. As I'm doing that, I'm curling Pat's chin up while putting my head right where his t-shirt tag would be. As I'm doing that, I'm going to squeeze and pull my legs in. Finishing out that gear. Couple details we were missing on Tuesday that I noticed from around the room. One, we were getting the head snap okay, but a lot of you guys were still grabbing like a traditional guillotine, like off to the side. My lock is right on his chin. I'm literally keeping my chin, my hands locked on his chin this entire time. That way when I sit here, I'm rolling his chin into his abs out. How many of you guys know who Josh Hanger is? I had the unfortunate pleasure of rolling with Josh Hanger. I believe I was a purple belt at the time. And Josh was coming off winning worlds as a black belt. It was his first title. And Josh abused me with that for the better part of 6 minutes. I think he hit 7 of them. I swear to God, it was probably the first time I had been guillotined in years and probably the last time I was guillotined. But he hits that grip, and when he grabs your chin, he is putting it through the back of your spine for some reason. It's the most violent shit I've ever felt in my life. If you've never watched him roll, I think he's from Indiana originally and went to IU and ran their jiu-jitsu club. Is he? Okay, yeah. I knew he went to graduate school at IU. And then is out at Atos. Most of you guys will know who Andre Hall is. His way, this is top trainer. So I'm here, head snapping into my chest here. Once I'm here, the other detail we were missing real big on Tuesday, a lot of us were falling straight backwards. We were crunching in and doing the right things there, but we're flat, which kind of gives you that like flipped turtle response in this position. You're like, I can't really move. Where if I'm on my side here and I need to adjust or elevate or do anything, I have the motion to do it. So when I'm here, the pass turns to do things that I like. I can elevate, I can sweep. There are a lot of options here. So make sure we're falling, just like last week, we're falling to our side, not straight back. Does that make sense? Start from the beginning, I'm here inside. Boom, I frame. Re-guard up. Push up. And I like to hit this as soon as we hit the top of this. Hip here, falling to my hip. Head to the back. Front. Pull it. Hey guys, my hands, I'm trying to literally put my hands through his. So a couple things are happening. So when I'm here, I'm pressing in, which is going to press his neck down. I'm physically cupping his chin like a football, old school head. Cupping that in and rolling it. So I'm forcing my wrist and hand through his throat. Right through the front. It's a real more of a bludgeoning choke. It's like, hey, you're not gonna get a lot of blood, but you're gonna get a lot of air. You guys realize while you're hitting this sweep, you're like, man, this isn't working. Like, you don't feel it. Couple options. You can sit back up and readjust. Or if you have a good grip on this, take time. You can always hit that simple butterfly sweep that's always there. They may have hands to base and stop it, but that'll also allow you to readjust your detail. Questions? Pops in. So I'm snapping him across kick to my knee. So if I'm here with Pat, we're rolling here, that's not going to be a smooth motion. So I'm here, I'm literally going to bring that hand back. Questions, all good questions, guys. Make sure we're asking stuff like that. If you need clarification, guys, realize I have to clarify this shit for myself before I teach it. So, there's a process. So, questions on any of that? Drill her out. One, two, three. Alright, so I'm here. I get to this position. I go to head snap, but he's smart and he digs instantly for this underhook. Not a problem. All I'm going to do is grab that same grip. I'm keeping everything else the same. The only difference is I'm not going to keep him off to the side. I'm going to center his head in my chest. So instead of keeping him off to the side that little bit, I'm just going to suck him into my chest. All I'm going to do, same thing, fall back, squeeze. If it finishes here, great. If not, you use it to sweep either that way, or because you have the arm trapped on this side, you can actually go backside as well. Couple details we were missing Tuesday. I head snap, I come over. A lot of you guys were leaving it way off, or like trying to like pass it way too far to the other side. I'm literally trying to either get it on my center line or just into my right pec. Right here into my chest. The other thing, when I'm falling back, I'm still going to my hip and my side here to finish. I'm going to loosen this grip so I can talk if Pat doesn't die. The other thing, when I'm here, still squeezing in, and I'm curling in with my legs as well. A lot of you guys were like leaving your legs either loose or you were like trying to extend him away from you. When I extend him away from me, I'm actually extending my grip. So if I have this grip here and I extend that, I'm giving him space to pop that head. So when I'm here, I fall back this way. If it's working, great. If not, I can't rotate back this. Questions on that? Same thing, just an arm in guillotine with one slide up. I sit up here, snap that head. Come over the top of that arm. Batty palm, on my hand, putting that in my chest. Finish it here. You can go this way. It's going to be a little bit harder because it's going to be more safe. But if I'm here, let's say this isn't working. All I'm going to do, close this bottom foot, rotate my hips up. Slight adjustment, just going arm in instead of no arm. Questions, comments, concerns? Anyone need to see it one more time? Alright, one, two. There's a lot of this. Alright, so I'm here, and let's say I'm a savage and I like to choke people with their pajamas. And I wonder why white belts think they can flip around. So I sit up here. I'm going to open this collar up just that little bit. Now I'm going to send that collarbone grip. Four fingers in, collarbone grip. I'm not reaching way to the back. I'm not reaching way low. My top knuckle should be able to just grind his collarbone that little bit. Alright? Once I'm here, all I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this collar down and around. Still the number one detail in this technique all you will fuck with. Most of you guys are going to pull this straight across and fuck up your grip. Down, then around. Makes it 10 times tighter, a lot less pressure on your wrist. Best details I learned years ago. Down and around. As I'm doing that, I'm going to snap his head down and pull in. As I'm here, I'm going to post my hand in and cut karate chop back towards Pat's shoulder. So I'm here, down, around, back. As I'm doing that, I'm pulling this in and up. Falling straight to the side here. I'm going to loosen up so that Patrick can breathe while I talk. So realize this is on the grip. This is the grip. But I'm going to show it like this so Pat doesn't stop. Around. As I'm here, I'm pulling towards the side, falling this way. Couple things. When I'm here, a lot of you guys just try to like pressure the head down. Down and back towards the shoulder. Alright? Questions on this? Just that simple loop joke, I love it. It's one of my favorites to hit from here, especially when you got a guy who's being real basic. You know, up his collar. Snap, boom. And it can be right there in a hurry. Corey was saying, if I'm here, the intelligent defense thing is guys will try to roll out of this and try to come through. A lot of sweet lob shots. The nice part is, at no point when you're countering this is there a good way to get out, so you almost have to abandon position and dive. So I'm here, grabbing my collar grip. Yes, I'm pulling him in with this the whole time. So when I'm here, the reason I'm pulling him in, because one of two things are going to happen. One, I can hit this and it's going to go up. Two, I'm going to lose my grip strength, something's going to go wrong. And I'm going to keep pulling him in and go up. I'm going to use all that pressure on the top of his head and just put it through. That's always going to be. Realize, guys, on all these jokes, even if I don't say it, there's always a sweep at the end of them. Because if the choke's not in and you're like, fuck it, what can I do? Two options, readjust, sweep. Always an option, butterflies. Why I play a lot of butterfly guard. Most of you roll a good up. I will sit and pull you in a butterfly guard. Questions? Ready? 1, 2, 3. And let's say I get this grip, I get it down and around, but I can't get Pat's head down. He starts to really posture up, things aren't working. I'm just gonna reach behind his head and grab this grip right here on the top of his shoulder. Like I talked about the other day, there's always something up here. I like grabbing that patch right here. As I'm here, I'm going to straighten his face away. My top hand is gonna go across his jawline. My bottom hand is going to pull in. As I'm here, I'm falling away from this. So I boom, we're here. Trip. Snap the head and he comes down. He postures his head up. He can sit down to get you. Set that grip and adjust. This hand is doing 90% of the work. My top hand is just framing his face away, and it's pressure. This hand, I'm full starting a lawnmower. It's the best way I can describe it. Lifting that this way. And as I'm here, I'm falling to the side, and quench, you know it. What's this choke's not working? Go, Scott. Take time, still have a problem. I go for that head snap. He postures his head up. Don't mind that. I'm going to set this top grip. Here. Fall. Pull. Push. One of the big mistakes we were making Tuesday, everyone was trying to like pop their chin. Would you can get decent pressure there, but someone who's got a little bit of jiu-jitsu experience is going to frame you out. When I'm here, this is across his jawline, almost in line with his nose. That allows me to base in here. Allows me to put all my pressure behind this choke. And I'm also falling to my side, not flat on my back. Weird detail, you almost never fall flat on your back, guys. Here. Questions? Nothing. Okay. So we're here. I got to roll on. I'm trying to do stuff, right? Boom. There goes Sam.
Good job.
Work. And a lot of guys, once you go to grab this grip, will roll their head out for you. For those of you guys with the gang warms, this is a fun one for you because you have a lot of pressure. Life's not fair though. Welcome to America. Questions, comments, concerns? Alrighty. Blue belts, you guys get an extra option. I'm gonna set this collar grip stupid deep. Almost like I'm trying to grab his t-shirt back. Pat's not gonna like that, so he's gonna roll his head up. And I'm gonna put my thumb right next to my pinky. Like I'm grabbing a baseball bat. Maybe this choke's called the baseball bat. Now, I'm gonna fall towards the hand that is pulled up. So I'm here, I grip way too deep. He rolls that head under. Here. Solid grip. I'm gonna fall towards this side. The second I hit my hip, I'm just gonna flatten this leg out. And I'm gonna help him pass my legs. You're all like, man, Dustin, why would you let him pass? Because all we're gonna do is walk our feet away. Throw him over my shoulder, pinching my elbows here. This is a baseball bat choke. One of my favorite chokes. One of my favorite all-time submission wins in a tournament. I choked a dude out and stood up with it. He was unconscious before we got to my feet. It was great. So I'm here. I grip way too deep. He's going to roll that head. Grab. Oh. Oh no, my butterfly sweep didn't work. Big details on this one. I'm gonna loosen my grip so that I can talk and Pat doesn't die because Carlos almost killed me in this one. I wish that was an exaggeration. I was not in a good spot. I'm here. As I turn, I'm trying to get him on my shoulder here like a baseball bat choke. I'm pinching my elbows, going all the way belly down. The big thing on this one is how tight you have your hands connected is how tight this choke is. So if your thumbs are wet and pinky, you're way far apart, not gonna work. Choke that grip up, actually like you're grabbing a baseball bat. That's why it's pulled, because you put it right here. Grip looks like you're grabbing a bat. Blue balls, questions on that? I just want to choke him. So I'm here, I grip way too deep, right? He rolls that head under. Boom, I'm here. Fingers close together. Oh, man, I'm gonna sweep. Did it work? It's one of my favorite traps to set on new people, because you're all like, yeah, I'm passing his card, and then it doesn't work out that way. It's really fun. I've done it to a lot of you. So, questions, comments, concerns on that? White belts, you're hitting that cross collar. Blue belts, you can try out the baseball bat if you want it. One, two, three.